Okay, so I just want to talk about the gospel, and you know, if you're feeling unfulfilled in life and feeling like you have no purpose, then you do have a purpose. And I just want to read a scripture for you, 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17 through 19, real fast. It says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. All this is from God, who through Christ reconciled us to himself and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting us to the message of reconciliation." So, right now, if you don't have Jesus Christ in your heart, if you haven't accepted him as your Lord and Savior, you can't have a relationship with God. You can't have a relationship with God, because God is holy, and sin is a barrier between us and God, right? He's a barrier. I got this picture here. So you have sin in the world. We're all sinners. We are all sinners. The Bible clearly says it. And it happened through Adam and Eve when they rebelled against God, and we got the curse of sin. And you can see it in the world. You can see sin in the world today. It's just rampant. It's bad. That's where everything that bad happened is from, sin in the world. And so, right, so you have this picture right here, right? I don't know if you guys can see this, but you have God, Jesus, then you have us, right? Sin is a barrier, right? We can't have a relationship with God. You see how it bounces off? Well, here now, look, Jesus meets us where we're at. You don't have to clean up your life. Jesus meets us where we're at. We have a relationship with Jesus. Look, come down here. We accept Jesus Christ into our hearts, right? You see this, Jesus? We have a relationship with Jesus. Look, our relationship flows through Jesus to God, and God's relationship flows through Jesus to us. We are reconciled with God, and we accept Jesus Christ in our hearts. Jesus Christ is the holy priest. He is the whole. When he died, when he rose up from the grave, when he died for our sins, the veil was torn in the Holy of Holies. Therefore, where we could have a relationship with God through Jesus. And I know that might be a little too broad, but pretty much is, you have to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. You got to have faith that Jesus rose up from the grave, right? Jesus defeated death. When he defeated death equals sin. When Jesus defeated death, he defeated sin. Jesus was sinless and knew no sin. And he took on the sin of the world, the sin of everybody. He took it on himself. He experienced God's wrath and God's fury that was for us. And the Bible says whoever accepts Jesus Christ into their hearts, whoever accepts my son shall have eternal life, shall have a relationship with me, receives the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit guides us through our lives. So, what now? Well, in order to believe that Jesus Christ rose up from the grave, you gotta have faith. You gotta have faith that Jesus rose up from the grave, right? Faith is having hope. You have hope that this happened. You believe God, the God that who wrote this Bible, is the truthful, you know. And the Bible says, you know, God keeps his promises. You know, he kept his promise through Abraham by giving him a nation, by creating a family to bless all the families, you know. And through Jesus, when you accept Christ, he makes you a new creation, right? Makes you a new creation. The old has passed. The old, all the sins that you've done, all the bad habits, is thrown away, and you are a new creation in God, in Christ. Doesn't mean you're perfect. Doesn't mean you'll ever be perfect. But it means that you have a relationship with your Heavenly Father, and that is what brings true fulfillment. Not a relationship, not your job. That is what brings true fulfillment. It's having a relationship with God himself through Jesus Christ. So I ask you, if you don't have faith that Jesus Christ rose from the dead, right? You might believe, yes, Jesus walked this earth. Yes, Jesus can be the Son of God. But I just don't know. I don't know if you're, like, that's crazy, right? Jesus, that somebody can rise up from the dead. Ask God. You don't have to have a lot of faith. The New Testament, Jesus said, have the faith at the size of a mustard seed. That's a little bit of faith, and it goes a long way. What we need is a faith in a great God, because God is great, and God is loving, and he's good. Ask God. Say, God, give me faith in your greatness. Give me faith in your son, Jesus. Show him. Give me faith. And then I urge you to read the New Testament. Read the Gospels. Study Mark and John and read it. Study Romans. Study it and read it. Seek Him. If you don't feel fulfillment in your life or purpose, seek God. Have faith. Ask God for faith in His greatness. Jesus Christ, having a relationship with Him, having a relationship with God through Jesus Christ, is what brings you true fulfillment, right? When you finally have faith that Jesus rose up from the grave and believe that He's your Lord and Savior, pray to God. Say, God, I know I'm a sinner. Forgive me for my sins, Lord. Lord, enter into my heart, Jesus. Jesus, enter into my heart. I believe You are the Son of God, and You rose up from the grave, and You defeated death and sin. I believe this, and I believe and I have faith that You will save my soul, save my heart, so I don't have to experience Your God's wrath. God, I want a relationship with You. I invite Jesus into my heart. Thank You, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I'm not pressuring anybody to accept Jesus as Lord and Savior. I'm not. I believe that I have found the answer to fulfillment in life. I believe I have found my purpose in life. And just the pure joy that God gives me is so much more than joy of any human could ever give me, any hobby could ever give me, any materialistic thing could ever give me. Trust me, I know. And I know I'm young, and you say, oh, you're young, you don't know anything. I mean, we all struggle with our own things, and so just have faith in God. And thank you guys. I love you. Peace.